Well, you know what today is?
Friday.
It's Flashback Friday.
Oh, great.
Yeah, so we're going to be flashing it all the way back.
Is that what that means?
Yeah, it really does.
Okay, what are we going to talk about then?
Well, we're heading back to our childhoods. What is the one thing you enjoyed as a kid that your kids won't experience? This is what we're talking about on hashtag Your Take Today. So we're going to look at some of the many things many of us enjoyed when we were younger that kids today just will never have a chance to experience. And maybe we didn't enjoy it, or maybe we did. But Am, I want to show a video that you posted on Instagram.
Oh, no.
Do you remember this one?
Oh, yeah.
Of something that many of us don't even see out on the street anymore. Take a look at this.
Yeah. Okay.
Take a look.
Okay, so you go up to the thing, and then you would put however much money you needed in here. Now there's a loony on there. It used to just be a quarter. What do you hear?
This is please.
That is so funny. We were on our way to the bathroom at Chapters, and she's like, what's that thing?
Yeah.
You know, I had a similar experience. We were at the airport, this is a couple months ago, and my daughter picked up the phone, like the pay phone, and was so confused because she picked it up and she heard something. Yeah. You know what that something was? A dial tone.
A dial tone.
She has never heard a dial tone before because I hadn't thought about that, but with our phones, we don't use those. Typewriter clicking, rotary phone
the whole
sounds.
Thing.
So many things.
Internet dial-up.
Yeah.
And you know what's so interesting? I was reading this article. Yes, I have a story about that one too. But yeah. I was reading this article because, you know, when you go to London, for example, it's the telephone booth that's such an iconic thing.
In England,
but you don't actually have telephones in those booths anymore. So you know what they're doing with them? Putting ATM machines in there.
Oh, smart. Really?
Yeah.
I love that.
Oh.
They're recreating it. Anyways, I thought that I'd just throw that out there. So, but we want to look at other things from back in the day. So we're not going to go all the way back in the day, but we're going to start off and slowly progress.
Mm-hmm.
What about CD collections?
Oh, yeah. I still have mine.
Still have yours?
Yeah, I have nowhere to play it, but I have them.
I have the CDs. I still play CDs. I just bought a CD.
Where do you play it?
On my CD player.
But where is that? Like, is that in your... No, but I'm asking, like, do you have one in your car still, or do you have one at home?
I play them in the car, and I also play them in my home.
Wow.
Okay. Yeah, well, speaking of CDs, let's go maybe a few years back, VHS.
Yes.
Do you remember when you had to tape your shows, if you wanted to tape your show on a VHS?
I still
then you had to, you had to click stop and record? Was it stop
That's
and record
right.
or something like that?
That's right.
But you had to rewind it all,
play and record.
Play and record. But you had to rewind it all the way back.
Yeah, you
remember?
Did.
Remember? Or else.
I actually, or else.
Be kind, rewind.
Exactly.
That's right.
Know.
I used to, I bought a VHS player when I was living in Halifax when I first moved there.
Yeah.
And I was working for CTV because I wanted to record shows.
Yeah.
And it cost me more to ship the VCR that I had ordered off one of those websites than it did the actual product.
Wow.
Yeah, because it was, and that was years ago, too.
Have you got lost recently? Have you got lost recently? I'm talking about, like, on the street.
Oh.
Because, you know, because now we have our GPS everywhere.
You mean in this conversation
everywhere.
Or just on the street?
No, we got it back. We got it back. No, but seriously, because now with GPS, if you want to walk somewhere, you just type it in to your GPS locator.
That's true.
And literally you can watch it
That's
on your
point.
Phone.
I feel like I'm going to have to teach my kids how to navigate using a map.
I know.
Because they only know Google Maps.
Okay, but in fairness, did you whip out a map?
Always. I love maps. I love being the navigator.
Like
I would
just
happen
to have
navigate.
A map that you would be like...
No, but it was always in the car.
Yeah.
Oh, that,
or when
you
go on a road trip, you know, and you would stop at the locations on the side of the highway to use the bathroom, but then you would go in and you would see, like, where you are located. Yeah. They would have the giant map of the state or the province that you're in.
Like a You Are Here sticker?
Yeah, and then after you would see, okay, how much further you have to go.
You know, the other thing that my kids were laughing at the other day is we told them you used to have to crank your window down.
Yeah.
You have to roll your window down yourself.
And that's like, a flashback. We were a lot stronger those days.
There's so many things. It's just gone so... I mean, we didn't have cell phones, obviously.
No.
We didn't have, which is so weird to think about now.
I know.
Back to the maps. Think about, you know, every car door has that little sort of like pocket or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
That was for maps.
I know.
Now what's it for?
Garbage.
Phone chargers.
That's garbage. Garbage. Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
And now we find our friends on, you know, social media. You search them up.
Mm-hmm.
But what about looking for your friends in the phone book? Did anybody used to just look for their name in the phone book feel like, wow, like, look at our house number in the phone book?
I know, people used to print their addresses and their postal codes
Can
and
you
everything
imagine
in
that?
The phone
your
book.
Whole personal information was out in the phone book for the whole world to see.
Well, it actually still is. It's just online.
I know. But
Canada 411, I believe.
Yeah. It's just such a change of events that's been happening.
Or that sound really late at night when the phone book arrived. It was like the on your front step.
Yeah.
You knew it was there.
Yeah.
Oh, memories.
Or developing film. When you take a picture, you didn't have a digital camera, so you could only take so many, and you know, you never knew what it looked like.
Yes.
So you just took the picture, and then
hope
you would see that, you hope for the best.
Oh my gosh, that's so
Now
true.
We just take 1,000, and then after we filter it up.
That was my day yesterday. taking pictures of Brandon in his upfront suit.
Yeah, it was a good suit. And you were looking, we were all looking pretty fly.
1000 though.
You
I
know
like
what
that,
I'm saying. So, Canada, I want to ask you a very personal question here. Can we have a family discussion on this Friday?
Let's do it.
And kids, you can chime in as well. What will your kids never experience? Mm. We listed a few, but I know you're thinking of more out there. Let us know. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. Hit us up. Right after the break, we have more news and weather.